Hi Flosstube. I'm back with another video. I'm going to talk about heaven and earth designs today because I think there's a lot of people that love them but don't want to try and tackle them because they are big. Most of them are big. Some are huge. I've only just started. This is my first heaven and earth design. It's called Becoming Brave by Terry Rosario. And I started on 18 count Ada because that's one of my most favorite fabrics. I'm doing 2 over 1, and it started off pretty good. I'm just gonna fill you in on what I've learned since I started. I started doing cross country. I looked at my pattern and thought, okay, well, there's fairly decent blocks of color. So I thought, well, I'll start doing cross country because I am a cross country stitcher. That's what I'd love to do. Started doing that and I ended up getting lost. Not terrible, but I got lost. So I started parking. Thought I'd try parking, and actually parking, it worked fairly well. You just have to be very diligent in marking your chart with highlighters. To make sure that, again, you don't get lost, because if you park in a spot and you don't mark it off, or you end up parking in a different spot and you mark off a different symbol, then your colors are going to get all mixed up. So you have to be very diligent in that. And I always enlarge my patterns. So I take one pattern page and split it into two. And it's easier to see for me, and it's also easier to mark off with the highlighter. So I did parking for, I guess, the next three pages. Up here, there's pages 1, 2, and 3. The fourth page only has three little rows on the side, so I don't even really count that page. I think the total in this pattern was, or is, 14 pages. But actually, there's really only 9. I count them as only 9 because, of course, the fourth page only has 3 rows. And then this is 5, 6, and 7. And then 8's only got 3 rows. And then 9, 10, and 11. 12 only has 3 rows. Maybe there's only 12 pages. Because I only have 3. This is the last of this page. And then I only have 3 full pages at the bottom. So 12 pages, I guess, you would consider that. So I parked, and I found I parked in 10 by 10 blocks, and I found it went fairly well. I watched Carolyn Mazzio's video on parking a couple times and got fairly confident that I could do it. So I did it, and it worked well. Then I got to this page. So I did the first 3 pages. Then I got to this page and I looked at the colors, and yeah, there was a whole lot of colors in here, but there was fairly decent blocks. I mean, not huge, but decent. So this page, I started working color by color, and I really did well with it. And that's how I've done these last couple pages. Now, when I got to the end, of course, I had a ton of single ones left, probably 50 or 60 single ones left. So the end of the page really took a long time because, of course, you're threading and you only have one stitch to do. But that's how I did this. And I got to here. I really don't like this side of the page, although it's getting into different color now. So this page, I actually started working in columns going across. I mean, rows going across instead of columns going down, because I didn't want to be left with all of these these colors over here. There's white, there's probably, well, they're so close in color. Although it kind of looks like, you can see the variation in color, but anyway, I started working this one in rows. So I'm just about done. I've only got two more rows and then a couple at the bottom there. But I did start a different heaven and earth design and took what I learned from this one and started the next one. Now, that one's rolled up in a drawer. I don't have it for you, but I can pull it out for a different video and show you. But I'm just going to tell you what I did. I actually ordered the 25 count magic guide from so and so in the UK, and I absolutely love it. I'm doing 1/1 on 25 count, and it's beautiful. I don't think I'll ever do another heaven and earth design another way. For me, it's called cross stitch because you make crosses. And I'm not saying that if you do 10 stitch or continental 10 stitch, two strands over one, that that's wrong. That's a personal preference. But for me, I have a really hard time not making that second leg of the cross to make it a cross stitch. So I've been stitching for over 25 years. And for me, unless the pattern calls for a half stitch, I automatically want to cross it. So I think I will always do cross stitch. And that's just my personal preference. Everybody cross stitches their own way. You find the way that works for you, and there is no right or wrong way. Is the end result is what it is. So I'm not judging anybody. I'm not trying to give advice to anybody saying that you have to do full crosses. You do what you feel comfortable with. But I really like the 25 count 1/1. And I actually started doing that one in columns. Well, again in columns, but not parking. What I do is I start at the top and I pick one color. Usually the symbol that shows up the least. And what I do with my pattern pages is I enlarge them. And then so on the first page I've got like from the end of or from the start of the first row is zero, of course, and then it goes down to like row 50, and then the second page will go from 60 or 50 to 90. I think most, well, I'm not going to say most because I don't know. The two heaven and earth designs that I've done, the page is 90 rows long. So I split that. And then what I do is I work in columns. So I'll pick the color that is the least or the symbol that shows up the least, and I'll do that. And I'll work down the whole page until I get to the bottom of the page. And then I'll go to my other page, the second photocopy. And this is where I got in trouble with this one. You really have to make sure that you mark off the, what do you call it, the join where your page overlaps. Because I got in trouble with this one on my first page up here. I thought it overlapped on this line. So I started, or I thought it overlapped on this line. So I started stitching up here and I did the whole column. I did 1200 stitches down. And then I went up here and I started doing, and I think I did 400 more. And then I realized that I had overlapped, that this row here was going to be the same as this row. So I had to unpick 1600 stitches. That was not fun. Very much discouraged me, but I kept going on it because, of course, it was on my first page and I really liked this one. So that's how I do it now. And that's how I'm probably always gonna do it. Now you do see a couple parked threads here because I do still park a little bit, but not completely. These ones are just left over from here, because some of these symbols weren't used over here at all. So then I just left them parked down for this next 10 by 10 block here, instead of cutting them. And most of the time I do cut them. I look to see if they're down here, and not a lot were left down here. So that's just what I do. So I do thread my needle probably more than when you exclusively park, but at least I don't have all the threads hanging. And for me, I'm not OCD by any means, but they kind of just got in the way. Like they just, I don't know. I like a clean surface. I just don't like threads and stuff hanging. Although, like I said, I do it a little bit. But because these ones can be brought over here and they don't really interfere here at all, then this is just what I've done. So So I'm almost getting done this one. I really want to get this one done before I start anything else. I've only just got the two Heaven and Earth designs on the go now. This one, and like I said, my other one I've done on 25 count magic guide from so and so. And I really like it. But anybody that's wanting to start a Heaven and Earth design, like Kate. At So She Sews on Instagram. She's been asking me, and I actually got in a very detailed direct message with her on Instagram about this. And she was the one that said, you should do a YouTube video because that's really, it really helps. And I thought, well, okay. And that was actually what prompted me to want to do this because maybe the way that I do it will help somebody because I know the fact that parking really does scare a lot of people because of the threads hanging and stuff. So that's just the way that that I've figured out works best for me. I find it goes faster if I work down a column one color at a time. And I guess I should finish that. I never did finish. Okay, so I start with usually the color that shows up the least. So maybe you might only have one or two stitches. And of course, you have to decide how far you want to run your thread at the back. And you know what? I'm actually going to switch over to my other Heaven and Earth design because it's going to be easier to show you. So I will be right back. Okay, this is my Jane Wooster Scott, the patchwork sampler that I started on the 25 count fabric, the magic guide from so and so, and I love it. The fabric is heavy and nice, and the stitches hold up really well on it. I really hope the camera doesn't shake too bad. I'm really trying hard to hold it still. Okay, so this is how I started this one. Pam Reed has an excellent video that talks about the waist knots, which is what you can see here. She has an excellent video that I probably watched six or seven times before I started. I have a thread hanging here because I changed over my projects so quick I didn't even finish stitching that color. Anyway, just never mind about that. So this is how I've done this project and I love it. I still work in my columns as you can see here. So I start at the top and right here is where my page breaks. So there's 20, 40, 60. So that's right where my page breaks. So that's how far I stitched down in one color. So again, I pick a color at the top and I stitch down. If that color is down here, then I will park it in this next block if it's there. If it's not, then of course I tie it off. Now how these waist knots work, this is how I do it. I can't really exactly remember how far Pam went over, but this is just what I do. Now, and I did make some mistakes over here, but I've gotten into it good enough now that I can, because these blocks here, the marked ones, are 20 by 20. Of course, on the pattern, your pattern grid lines are 10 by 10. So I usually mark a little mark in the center for reference. But what I do is when I start a 10 by 10, I go over 30 stitches. And one thing that you have to make sure of is, let me grab a needle here. One thing that I've figured out is make sure that you are on the other side of the 10 line. Because when I started, I just was poking through kind of wherever and realized that I was on the 8th or the 9th hole. Well, then when you get into this, when you snip these ones, as you work over and you snip these waist knots off, I realized that I had to snip these off too soon because they were in my 10 by 10 block. So I always make sure that I'm on the other side of the 10 line. And this one actually here, that's just on the 11 line. So I can get really close to that before I have to snip it off. And what I like about this is you don't have to turn your work over. Now I have the kind of stand that it's really easy to flip over. It's like super easy to flip over. So for me, it really doesn't bother me to flip my work over because this is the most awesome stand. I absolutely love it. And I should probably get into that on another video another day. And I probably will, but not today. So this is great because you don't have to flip your work over. So you tie a knot in the end of your thread and you go down from the top. Don't pull too hard. Don't pull the knot too tight. And then you come back up over here and you start stitching. So I've got a few left to fill in here, as you can see. And I still weave in the back every now and then. Like I don't have a ton of waist knots because I still do weave in the back every now and then, but not a whole bunch. And I don't weave through. Let me just flip it over again. I don't weave through the stitches, the actual stitches. I weave through the thread that's going back and forth. There's the back of the work. For a heaven and earth design, I don't think it's terrible, but you can't have a neat back unless you have blocks of color like these white ones down here. Now these threads here, I did snip off early because of doing that white. They really tack down really, really well. But as you can see here, as you start stitching your next 10 by 10 block, all of these are gonna get tacked down really good, like here. So once you get over to this pink line, you can snip these off because you're gonna have 20 stitches of tacking these down, so they're never going to come out. So this is how I do it. And I find working in the columns just works quicker. And if you do make a mistake, you'll find it fairly quickly. And most of the time, you'll only be one square off. So if you end up switching it, which this happens to me, not a whole lot, but I'll end up just switching it with the symbol that it was supposed to be right next to it. And in the grand scheme of things, nobody's ever going to know. I mean, I can't even tell back here where I switched them, and you're never gonna see it. So I work down. If you pick a color that's very like a not common color, and you stitch a stitch there, and then you stitch a stitch here and down here and down here, you kind of zigzag down the whole row or down the whole column. And then when you use at the end, when it starts getting filled in more, and you use some of the colors that show up a little bit more, you're always tacking down that thread that you started with. That's why I start with the color that's the least, not the most common color. Like in these trees, there's lots of symbols that show up a lot. So pick one that doesn't show up a lot, because if you save that color until last, then that, say you've got that stitch right there, then you don't have another stitch like that symbol until down here. So that thread then is going to be running on top of all of the stitches that you've already stitched. But if you do that one first and you run it that far, then when you do all the rest of these stitches, it's going to tack that thread down. Now you're still going to have threads at the back that are going to be running. That's just inevitable with a heaven and earth design. But if that happens, what I do, and I'll flip over again here, I will tuck it underneath. Like I will flip my frame over, and I will tuck it under some of these. That, like that one right there, see that kind of creamy color, whatever, I ran that one pretty far, but I tucked it underneath that red one just so that I wouldn't snag it. So and I'm not tucking it under or through any stitches, so my stitches aren't going to be my stitches aren't pulling from the front. I'm just tacking it under other thread that's going across. So this is how I do it, and I really, really have enjoyed starting it like this. Now, lots of people do heaven and earth designs on all sorts of fabric. You can use whatever you want. I suggest you test stitch first, obviously, because you would hate to do a page or two and then not like it. So definitely test stitch. I mean, it all depends on your eyesight. You know, people use magnifiers. I have a really nice light that makes it really bright, and I actually don't stitch with my glasses on. I have to use my glasses to look at the pattern, but I don't stitch with my glasses on. So if I can have the pattern, I usually have the pattern needle mindered right to my stitching so that I don't have to put my glasses on. And I can stitch for hours. My eyes don't get sore. I can stitch for a whole day and be fine. So it depends. If your eyes get tired, then go with the 18 count. They do make an 18 count with the magic grid lines on it. And then your holes aren't so small, because going from an 18 count to a 25 count, that's quite a big difference. That's going from two strands then to one strand. And this is one strand, and I think the coverage is great. I'm really happy with it. But again, it's personal preference. So this is just what I do. And I thought maybe some of you might get something out of this, especially doing the columns, because I really found that the parking took time. I find this goes faster for me, and because I'm doing full crosses and not a tent stitch, it is going to take twice as long for me to get it done. Now I'm thankful that I don't work, and I can stitch all day long if I want, but it's still going to take quite a while to do it. My other one, the little Indian boy, I've been working on him for almost a year, but that's not exclusively. I started doing a rotation last year, just after I started him, I think, or just before I started him. So I think with heaven and earth designs, especially one like that, or anyone really, to work on it exclusively, I think you could get burnt out. It's just too much of the same thing all the time, unless you're doing like the bookshelf or some of those that are really, really super detailed. And I guess it's a personal preference. I'm sure there's people that work on heaven and earth designs exclusively, and that's fantastic. I just find that it's nice to have a little variety. For 25 years, I've been a one project at a time person. I've never even dreamed to work on two things at once, and I actually quite enjoy it. It gives variety. Not that I get bored or frustrated with something, but it's just nice to have something else to go to when it's kind of like, well, I don't want to work on trees anymore, so let me pick up something different. Or I don't want to work on the right side of that little Indian boy because of all those darn colors that are so close together. So then you work on it for a week or two or a month, and then you put it away and come back to trees and sky. So, yeah. So those are just my viewpoints. I don't think I forgot to tell you anything. Because I'm holding my camera, or I'm holding my phone, I really can't demonstrate. Of course, when you make a waist knot, first of all, you've got your two hands, so you can make the knot really easy, and then you push your needle through. When you tie it off, I use my two needles to try and get the knot as close to the fabric as I can, and that way there's not any slack in behind. And then once you tack it down, then it pulls it quite tight, and it holds it nice. But I loop my thread, and then I use my left hand with a needle, and I hold it in the loop, and then I pull with my right hand. I pull my thread and my needle with my right hand. And when you hold the loop with your left hand with a needle, then you can get the knot as close to the fabric as you can, and I find that works best. Yeah, so I think that's about it. So again, like I say, I work down this column to the 60 line here, and then once I'm done that part, then I'll get my other page out and I'll work to the bottom. And now I'm getting into sky, so this bottom page is pretty much all white. So that goes really fast. I'm liking that. And actually, I think once I get over into sky here more, there's lots and lots of white. So that's going to go really quick once I can get there. But I think I've got another half a page of tree here. So anyway, if you have any questions or comments, leave them in the description box below, or leave them in the comments below. And yeah, thanks for watching. I appreciate everybody that's watched my first video. That was just yesterday. I posted that. Because I really didn't show anything or teach you guys anything, I just kind of rambled a little bit about me. I figured I would fire off another one today and talk about this heaven and earth designs, which so many of us are doing. And I love seeing everybody's videos and pictures on Instagram and watching everybody's Flosstube videos. I'm really happy that I can be here and maybe share a little bit of what I've learned with you. So any questions or comments, leave below. Please like my video. Please subscribe if you like my videos as well. And yeah, happy stitching, and we'll talk to you again soon.